When people think of scientists, the first thing they see is a person in a white lab coat. I guess this is where I'm different. I love motorbikes, and I'm actually learning to ride one. I enjoy getting on the road with friends. In my minimal downtime, I like eating out and baking. I love science, and I'm trying to understand and cure motor neuron disease at the University of Queensland. I guess I've always had a sense of adventure, and I think this is partially why I chose science as a career. When I was younger, I was really obsessed and really in love with this comic book series called The Adventures of Tintin. And he was this reporter and adventurer who would travel the world with his dog Snowy, acting like a detective, fighting crime and fighting injustice. And I really think that it was The Adventures of Tintin that made me really want to choose science. Discovery through adventure is not something that I was really interested in. I guess my family background has really played a big part in making me who I am today. My Chinese parents were refugees and they travelled here to Australia and they worked really hard to give us a better life than something better than what they ever had and what they ever lived when they were younger. And it's worked out really well for us. I've got 7 siblings, 5 brothers and 2 sisters, and they're all really successful in all fields ranging from analytical chemistry to IT, marketing, digital photography and I guess animation. That's what they all do. And it's this strong work ethic that my mother instilled in me which is really driving the passion that I have for motor neuron disease research. My research is really aimed at trying to understand how a change in the way the body uses energy can affect the onset of motor neuron disease between people and how it might also affect how quickly the disease progresses between one person to the next. Food, diet and maintaining energy balance is really important for people living with motor neuron disease. On an emotional level, I become very invested with our patients, particularly when we're doing our research studies. A lot of the patients tell me that they feel like scientists tend to speak at them rather than to them. And so I spend a lot of effort trying to help them understand the research that we're trying to do, and they in turn can understand how important their contribution is to the future of a cure for motor neuron disease. Unfortunately, sometimes this passion and investment, emotional investment in my research can really get stuck in my head. And every now and then I have to get out on the back of the bike to blow out the cobwebs so that I can clear my mind and relax a little. My name is Dr. Shyuan Ngo, and people call me Shu. I am a scientist at the Queensland Brain Institute and the School of Biomedical Sciences, and I want to cure motor neuron disease.